I know some of my viewers are going to be quite surprised to find out that Nicholas Flamel is not just a character from the Harry Potter books, but a real 14th century alchemist, in fact one of the most famous other than Paracelsus. This is Nicholas Flamel's Hieroglyphical Key, published by Ouroboros Press. It's another one of their beautiful, beautiful editions. There are three editions that currently exist. There is, let me see, they're all limited editions. So there's a vellum edition, there are 26 copies of that, 72 copies of this leather-bound version, and 679 copies of the cloth copies. I would love to have the other two, but I am one of the common mortals with a regular salary. and so I'm making do with this, which, I'll be honest with you, it's so lovely. It's, let me just get the light on this cover, which is made with a traditional letterpress, and you can see how the letterpress has embossed the paper. Ouroboros Press really make an effort to make books in a very traditional style, and with using all traditional technologies, and the result is really quite visible. Let me tell you a little bit about the book while I show you how beautiful this book is. Basically, Nicholas Flamel was incredibly rich. Nobody's really 100% sure how he came about this wealth, but his story is that he turned a load of lead into gold, of course, possibly mercury into silver, and then gold. That's another of his theories. And one of the things that he did with that money is that he created some arches for the St. Innocent's Cemetery in Paris. Now, the St. Innocent's Cemetery in Paris no longer exists, thank goodness, because it was a tiny, tiny cemetery which was supposed to serve the whole of Paris. And very quickly it got full, and then started to overflow. And by the time of the revolution, they were basically piling up. They weren't even bothering to try burying the bodies anymore. They were piling up those bodies outside the cemetery, which made the neighborhood quite unpleasant to visit, as you can imagine. But anyway, at the time of Nicholas Flamel, it wasn't that bad yet. And he had some arches commissioned and painted. And those paintings, he decided what would be on the paintings, and those paintings give details on what the alchemical process is. This book describes what is on those paintings. It actually reproduces those paintings as woodcuts, and then describes what they're supposed to be representing. So I'm showing you right now what the chapters are, what the contents are. There's an introduction. First of all, there's a preface by the publisher, which is fascinating, really, really interesting. If you're into magical adventures, the life of Nicholas Flamel is definitely worth reading about. William Kissel, who's the owner of Ouroboros Press, has done a fantastic job of making that information available and in a very fascinating way. And then you've got the hieroglyphical figures. It's not the only book in the book. There are two other books in the back, being the Nicholas Flamel's Summary of Philosophy and the Testament of Nicholas Flamel, where he explains the process, the alchemical process, in a more concise way. However, he does say that all of this information is pointless if you don't know what the prima materia is, the basic material, the most fundamental material on which all creation is made. Now, if you've watched my previous video on Carl Jung's alchemy and psychology, you may have an idea, possibly, of what that prima materia is. Give you a clue. It's not physical. So here are the reproductions of some of the images that are on the arch. In the introduction, there are seven of them, and then there are in the individual chapters there are additional illustrations. Do, do, do. Here we go. Which of course are beautifully restored and dissected. I was a little bit sorry not to have a complete picture, although you can actually imagine what the full arch would have looked like just by looking at the individual parts of it. A quick search on the internet will actually show you all of these parts put together. So yeah, the full picture was not available in the it just wasn't put together in the original work, and so this being a facsimile, it doesn't have that full picture. But I will link the full arch all put together as one big work of art in the description below, so you can check that out. In the meantime, I really strongly recommend checking out Ouroboros Press's website. And if you like this particular book, have a look as well at the Zoroaster's Telescope, which I'll also link below. And I'll be making a couple more on, two more books that I've received from them, one by Paracelsus and one Elias Ashmole's Theatrum Chemicum Britannicum, which is also, in fact, it's probably the nicest of the four books that I've received. I'll do that one last, but these ones are so lovely. I hope you like them. Please give me a thumbs up if you did like the video, and please subscribe. I'm really looking for as many subscriptions as I can at the moment. The subscriptions is what I'm mainly looking for right now. So if you know anyone that you can share this video with who might be interested, please do so. And thanks as always for watching. I really appreciate your time, and I will see you very shortly with the next video. Take care. Bye.